Let's now get an update on the local weather from PAGASA forecaster Veronica Torres. Veronica, over to you.
Good afternoon to you and to all of our audience in ANC. Currently, the southwest monsoon is still affecting the western section of Visayas and also the Luzon area. Because of southwest monsoon, we're expecting cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over Ilocos region and also Zambales, Mabuyan Islands, and Batanes. For Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we're expecting partly cloudy to cloudy skies with chances of localized thunderstorms. We don't have any gale warning raised over any parts of the country, and we're not monitoring any low pressure area inside the Philippine area of responsibility. Although there is a tropical cyclone outside the Philippine area of responsibility, it doesn't have any direct effect over any parts of the country, and it's moving away further from our landmass. And that's the latest from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. Veronica C. Torres reporting.
Thanks a lot, Veronica. An intense solar storm brings the northern lights to parts of the world. NASA said the level of 4 geomagnetic storm, the second highest on a scale of 5, was observed Monday. These conditions persisted for several hours, bringing the aurora borealis in U.S. states including Alabama and Northern California. The northern lights are also seen in parts of Canada and Europe. House lawmaker Paulo Duterte has filed a bill that seeks mandatory drug tests on the president and all other government officials. Vivian Gulia on the line now with that story. Viv, what more can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. Davao City First District Representative Paulo Duterte has filed a bill seeking to mandate random drug tests on elected and appointed government officials, including the president. Under House Bill 10744, the random drug test will be conducted through hair follicle drug test, and if the individual tests positive, a confirmatory urine drug test will be conducted. According to the measure, any official found positive for use of dangerous drugs shall be dealt with administratively, which shall be a ground for suspension or termination from office, subject to certain pertinent laws. The bill, meanwhile, states that candidates for electoral posts may undergo voluntary hair follicle drug tests within 90 days prior to the elections. In his explanatory note, Duterte said that considering the initiatives towards the deterrence of drug use and abuse, exemptions or favors in the mandatory nature of random drug testing shall not extend to certain class privilege, such as the elected and appointed officials. He added that since it becomes imperative upon their own mandate that they shall lead the life of modesty and integrity, they should also be subject to random drug tests. For Kabataan Party List Representative Raul Manuel, the bill needs to be carefully studied, noting that the drug problem is a health problem and should not be used in any political agenda. He added that the proposal could violate individuals' right to privacy. Manuel considers the bill a disruption to the International Criminal Court investigation into the Duterte drug war. Last January, Representative Duterte's father, former President Rodrigo Duterte, had accused his successor of drug use, and President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. had said that the verbal attacks against him could have been prompted by the alleged use of a powerful opioid painkiller, adding that he did not want to dignify the accusation. Former President Duterte later denied calling Marcos Jr. a drug addict. And according to the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency, Marcos Jr. has never been on the drug watch list. Carmina, back to you.
All right, Viv. You know, there is some sense to the bill that is being proposed. But the fact that he's the one who's proposing it, the same guy who's being linked to drug smuggling, is it getting any support from his colleagues? They're considering as well that there seems to be a line that's now dividing those who are supportive of the president and those supportive of the former president, Rodrigo Duterte. Having said that, Viv, is this bill getting enough support from his colleagues? What's the sense you're getting?
Well, according to our interview with some lawmakers, junior lawmakers here at the House of Representatives, they are saying that they are open to supporting the bill, but that it should be applied fairly. And it should not only include government officials or elected or appointed government officials, but should also include or cover officials and personnel in local government units so that it could be applied fairly. But then it should. They are also questioning if it is related to the Supreme Court case, which deemed unconstitutional the mandatory drug test on candidates for public office, which essentially makes the drug test a qualification for candidacy. So these issues they will have to discuss during the committee deliberations on the said bill, which the lawmakers hope Representative Duterte will attend and be able to defend his proposal. Hermina.
All right. Thanks a lot. Vivian Gulia there joining us on the line.